Why isn't my Vlookup working? Oh boy, if I had a penny for every time I was asked that, I'd probably have quit YouTube by now. But until that day comes, today I'm here to guide you through fixing the 4 most common Vlookup errors. And if you stay with me till the end of this video, I'll share a neat little trick that'll automatically correct the most frequent error of them all. Alright, let's dive into the first error. This one occurs when your lookup range decides to shift. On our table here, we've got the performance stats for your sales team. It includes each salesperson's name, their sales, and their level based on those sales. Our goal is to figure out what commission percentage they're eligible for based on their sales level. Each sales level is linked to a specific commission percentage. For example, a level 1 salesperson earns a 5% commission, level 2 earns 7%, and so on. As you can see, we've already calculated the commission percentage for the first salesperson using a VLOOKUP. The lookup value is the salesperson's level. The lookup range is this table right here with the commissions by level, and we're telling Excel to fetch the value from the second column, which is the commission percentage. That's why it tells us that the first salesperson, Alex Johnson, who is a level 3, gets a 10% commission. We check our lookup table, and yes, it matches perfectly. But when we drag the formula down to the next salesperson, we encounter an error. Why is that? The formula was working perfectly for the first salesperson. This is actually a very common error. We forgot to fix the lookup range. If I double-click to inspect the formula, you'll see that the lookup range shifted down one row. While in the first formula, the lookup range covered from F2 to G6, after dragging it now spans from F3 to G7. This new range includes an empty row and skips the first row, which is where the commission for level 1 salespeople is, coincidentally the level of our second salesperson. That's why we get an error, because the value is not available in the adjusted range. The fix for this is pretty straightforward. You just need to remember to fix your range so that when you drag the formula down, the range doesn't shift and omit rows. To do this, go to your original formula and press F4 to fix the range. And there you go. Now, when you drag the formula down, it accurately calculates the commission for the next salesperson. Let's move on to the second error, which occurs when your lookup value is in the wrong format. If we take the formula and then drag it to the next salesperson, we hit another NA error. But why, since we've already fixed the range? If you look closely, Excel has flagged your lookup value with a green triangle in the upper right corner. This is how Excel alerts you to a potential error. By clicking on the cell and then the exclamation mark, Excel reveals that the issue is because your lookup value is text, not a number. While it might seem trivial, for a VLOOKUP, the format is critical. Although to us, a 4 as text and a 4 as a number may seem the same, to Excel, they're different. Correcting this error is quite easy. If you click on the exclamation mark again, Excel will offer to convert this text into a number. Select that option, and just like that, the problem is solved. The third error happens when your lookup value isn't exactly the same. Let's say we drag our formula down to the next salesperson, and there's another NA error. Now what? The range is fixed, and Excel isn't flagging the value as text this time. Here's the problem. When we select the value, the truth is revealed in the formula bar. That 4 isn't just a 4. It's actually a 4.32, but with its decimals hidden. Since it's not the exact number, Excel throws a NA error because it can't find level 4.32 in your commission table. And makes sense, because there is no level 4.32. To tackle this, we could manually remove those extra decimals. But what if other rows also have hidden decimals? It's not practical to adjust them one by one. This is where the round formula comes in handy. Simply wrap your lookup value in a round function within your VLOOKUP formula. Specify after a comma that we want no decimals by setting it to 0, close the parenthesis, hit enter, and your error is corrected. Lastly, the fourth error. This one's particularly sneaky and happens to the best of us. But before we get to it, remember to hit the subscribe button. Every week, I'm going to give away a complete Excel course worth $297 to 10 of my subscribers. Now, the fourth error, hidden blank spaces. Imagine we're now looking to match the commission percentage based on the salesperson's name. On the right, you have a table similar to the previous one, but instead of levels and commissions, it lists specific names and their corresponding commissions. The process to find the commission is the same. We set up the VLOOKUP, select the name as the lookup value, choose the whole table as the lookup range, which we remember to fix with F4 this time. Specify that the commission percentage is in column 2, and by writing false, we signal we need an exact match. But then, another NA error pops up. Why though? The range is fixed, and both the data are text values, supposedly matching exactly. Or do they? Let's verify. At a glance, they appear identical, but they're not. Notice what happens when we use the len formula, which tells us the number of characters in the text. We open a len formula, select the cell with Fiona Chen's name in our main table, and it shows 11 characters. Now let's do the same with the name in the lookup table. We open another len formula, select Fiona Chen, and it shows only 10 characters. What's going on? If we double-click on the name in the main table, we realize it has an extra blank space at the end, making it a different text for Excel. It sounds silly, but for Excel, Fiona Chen and Fiona Chen blank space are not the same, making this error one of the trickiest to spot. To resolve it, you could manually delete the space. But what if other names have the same issue? We can't feasibly check them all one by one. Remember the hack I mentioned for fixing errors automatically? That's where the trim function comes into play. It removes all extra spaces from a text, except for single spaces between words. So, just like with the round function, open your VLOOKUP formula, type trim before our lookup value, and close it in parentheses. Close your formula, and there, it's fixed. But wait, there's another salesperson to check. Let's see what happens when we drag the formula down. Another error. What did we do wrong this time? Hold on, I've spotted the issue. We're getting an error because we're trying to find Lindsay Brader in our table. And it turns out we don't have a commission record for her. So what can we do in this situation? We can't send out this report with errors in it. Well, we could use the if-error function to tell the VLOOKUP that if it encounters an error, to return non-existent record instead. With this function, you'll have all the tools you need to tackle errors in your VLOOKUPs. But how to use this function is something I'll teach you in the next video. See you there!